you know, you hit me too. And so I was asking Durrell about his love for horses. Like, you know, I know you live in, a, you know, Atlanta proper, mm-hmm. and you know, you have a horse. So how does that facilitate? Like, do you have space? And you know, you told me, yeah, the horse is mine and I have this acreage and mm-hmm. I have a home and I built the stable and the horse lives with me. And then that turned into, you know, this culture of black horse riders, like mm-hmm. no friggin' idea. Like,
nobody knew.
Let's tell the 3,000 to 4,000 people that are going to download this in the first couple hours.
If you come to Atlanta, so you're going to come into the airport. And the airport is in an area in Atlanta called Camp Creek Parkway.
Yeah.
And Camp Creek is the predominantly black side of town. Like, that's just where a lot of us is. It's a very nice area. A lot of wealth and stuff like that. But in that, there's a lot of what us old Atlanta people called like Atlanta style homes, which are, when we grew up, there was a lot of acreage, there was a lot of space. It wasn't rolling hills or anything, 2-3 acres. And I grew up seeing a group of African-American horsemen that rode in and out of the city, like all the time, just, and the horses were just as cool, calm and collected, you know, beautiful horses, well taken care of. And as a child, my mom, coming out of the hood, she wanted to make sure that we always, my brother and I, but particularly me in this case, always had experiences that would get us, you know, again, sharing new traditions, building on it. It goes back to that, right? Yeah. She was building a new heritage and tradition and for my family that stuck. I don't think she knew it would stick. Well, I remember as a kid, man, like these guys would come out and in the city, like right across the street from this Amoco gas station. And it was this little patch of grass, like it was not big. And they would set up a little corral and just have young black kids riding. And it stuck. So fast forward, you know, into, you know, my career into bird dogs and quail. That's a part of Georgia's tradition, is running dogs off of horseback, stuff like that.
Yeah, which again, I had no idea about that either.
Yeah, it's a thing. It's plantation culture. It's all of that stuff. Well, living in Atlanta, where was I going to get a horse? Right.
Like, wouldn't even cross my mind.
Most people it wouldn't. Well, I'm good buddies with Eric Frazier, who's the dog man at El Sama Plantation. Eric is also from the same side of town as I am up here in Atlanta. He just moved down there. Well, he's got a cousin here in Camp Creek, right? In that same area that just so happened to be selling the right kind of gated horse that I need, right? And it shows like how life cycles back around, and you never know the various cultures and the types of people that you live next to.
Yeah.
You know, and the secrets of various cities, right? Like how deep that kind of stuff goes. And so, you know, when I got the horse, she was just as cool, calm and collected, doesn't budge around cars, all really good around kids, you know, feet look good. I mean, everything checked out. And so it was just the right kind of decision. And that was the icing on the cake, you know, for all of my guiding and bird dog work and stuff like that.